Alright, ladies and gentlemen, those in between are neither, we are live! Welcome back to the channel, I'm your host. And today, it is Monday, so we're going to delve more into Genshin Impact's Archon Quest. Last time, we had a little bit of trouble dealing with the Delusion Factory, as Tepei was tragically drained of his life force. To kind of give a recap, or at least not... It's not so much a recap, but... what we did after that. I did manage to get some help from my co-op partner, and thanks to them, we were able to learn that Scaramouche is actually behind this whole shebang. And unfortunately, we weren't going to make it out if a kitsune by the name of Yamiko hadn't decided to come and help us. And now... we've kind of been conscripted, I think that's the right term here, to help her in what she needs to, or what she needs to do, What that is exactly, I don't know, but we're going to find out. And we have made it. Thank you for making it. How are you?
We're gonna do it here? And what's this mechanism for?
Good question.
Think of it as a catalyst that can reproduce the Raiden Shogun's combat moves. I made it from my own memory, which means it should be perfectly accurate. Unless, of course, her skills have declined.
I doubt it?
It'll give you a chance to figure out her moves in advance and come up with a counter-strategy. That should be a big help, don't you think?
Yes, it should.
The aim is to try to not get hit by the attacks. Since you've escaped certain death at her hand once already, I presume this shouldn't be more than you can handle?
Maybe? I am concerned about this. I am very concerned, but I am going to do my best. Start the challenge. Well, that didn't work. So the goal is to just dodge. So we dodge! But to be fair, I'm being shielded! Oh boy. I'm being shielded. Oh boy. Okay. Cool. We did the first part of that, which is basically just trying not to die.
What a workout.
That it? Paimon, did you forget that Yamiko is her friend? And if certain sources are to be believed, that they are more than friends? Hmm? Posing the question.
Perhaps it's because I'm the Electro Archon's familiar.
Yes. Don't be rude.
It sounds like you'd be more persuaded if you saw me in my fox form.
Please. Aww.
More curious than my appearance is the fact that she and I don't see each other anymore, wouldn't you say?
I mean, yeah, but people drift apart.
For all eternity is a dream that she and I both share. But I don't think that's the same thing as complete stasis.
Wait.
At some point, she started going down a path that became increasingly difficult for me to join her on. You know, A never said goodbye to me before she stepped into the plane of Euthymia.
Aww.
Perhaps it's just my wishful thinking, but I think she did this deliberately, as a way of keeping our friendship eternal.
Or at least she's trying to keep the friendship eternal.
By neither saying goodbye nor seeing me again, our relationship will remain forever how it was. In her mind, at least.
She's taken a very one-sided view.
Since we've embarked on two very different paths to eternity, I can either continue to maintain the status quo or do whatever it takes to bring her back on track, regardless of the cost. I have chosen the latter because if stubbornly isolating herself in the plane of Euthymia is her idea of eternity, then my duty as her eternal familiar is to drag her back out of her own head and into the real world.
Honestly, yeah. Friend isn't exactly the term I would use here. And considering that my partner is also in chat, yeah, sometimes we do have to kind of pull each other out and just say no, stop it.
I'm only telling you this so you can properly understand my plan. Could you possibly spare the sentimentality for the time being?
Sorry. It's a not to be.
Anyway, that's enough chit-chat. Time for anti-Raiden Shogun training phase two.
Phase two?
There's a part two?
Honestly, I'm not surprised. Alright. We're trying not to die. Oh! Hey, there are monsters now. That's fun. Switch into Scene Show. Flip into his water swords. Go into Barbara. Set up her droplets. You go into Risley and proceed to beat the crap out of everything. So yes, I'm sorry about the lag. Ow. Hey. Can you not? Wrongly. Pillar, please. Thank you. Scene show, we will use your water swords. Barbara's droplets are not ready to go. Barbara is the only thing that slows down this freeze team. And that's no fault of her own, it's just... she's just slow, that's all. Only. Thank you! Meteor to the face. Going in. With that, bringing up Barbara's droplets. And this Helotrol is about to have a very bad day. I love to see it. I'm going to correct you there, because it's not so much as A is panicking, it's she's shutting herself off from the world around her, and Yamiko's the one that's doing the, no, that's a problem, we need to face the issue.
We're finally done! How did we do?
You did quite admirably. I could see your determination and your hard work.
So do you think we're ready to beat the Raiden Shogun now?
Probably not.
How do I put this? You're no match for her at all.
Wait, what? So all of this was a complete waste of time?
Not exactly. This is Yi talking about. She's probably got a plan.
You are the most important part of the plan. I know what I'm doing. You don't think I'd leave you with no chance to win at all, do you? Speaking of, Traveler, what do you think of the Resistance Army's chances?
To be honest...
You're absolutely right. Perhaps they occasionally best the Shogun's army in open battle. But when they face the Raiden Shogun herself... Considering even their visions have been taken from them and embedded in the statue, they're ultimately quite helpless.
You don't have to be so blunt. The Traveler's the captain of Swordfish too, you know.
Paimon, there are some days, some events, that I wish you would stop talking. This is one of them.
I don't mean to belittle them. On the contrary, it is precisely because of their helplessness, because their visions have been taken from them, that their will is all the more precious. In short, if everything goes according to plan, they may yet prove to be helpful.
So, what is the plan?
Oh, goodness. Is that the time? I have another guest to receive today. We can talk more back at the Grand Narukami Shrine.
Yes, ma'am. Don't worry about it. Yimiko is effectively one of Alex's characters in D&D, where all of his cards are held somewhat close to his chest, and he only reveals them when he absolutely needs to. To which, I don't blame him for doing that. Should be teleporting in a few moments. Game? Now's not the time to freeze. Oh dear. Oh, never mind. So yeah, Yimiko is just not going to reveal the cards. And while I'm waiting on the loading screen, I should detail the rest of the week out for you guys because, well, it's kind of my job. On Wednesday, we are going to be doing another Genshin stream. Just as I say that... Welcome to the shrine.
Okay, we can talk here. You asked me about the plan. In fact, I've been mulling it over for quite a long time. Before one makes a plan, what is the most important thing one must do?
Don't know. What is it?
Consider your enemies and all the options.
You must understand the situation you are facing.
She puts it a little bit better than I do, but yes.
The Vision Hunt Decree was obviously devised as a means of manipulating the Shogun. The ones behind it knowing full well her susceptibility as a puppet, with a single-minded focus on eternity.
The Belladeer confirmed this.
This is the strongest piece of evidence we have to go on. Now... We also know that every aspect of the Vision Hunt Decree's promulgation and execution has been enthusiastically spearheaded by the Tenryo Commission from the outset.
Ayaka was saying that every time they submitted a petition against the Vision Hunt Decree, the Tenryo and Kanjo Commissions would veto it straight away with no negotiation.
So the Tenryo Commission is working for the Fatui, and the Kanjo Commission betrayed the Shogunate a while ago. So,
yes.
Yeah, it's this is
too clear that both the Tenryo and Kanjo in some form of collusion with the Fatui. Foolish humans, blinded by their greed.
Says the Kitsune.
Thus, the current situation is that our Fatui antagonist is still at large, has the two rogue commissions wrapped around their finger, and is distributing delusions from the shadows. Unfortunately, given that said antagonist is under the protection of two commissions and the Raiden Shogun, we would be rather hard-pressed to track them down.
So, what should we do?
It will be easier for us to start with someone from Inazuma. So my plan is to incite rebellion in the Tenryo Commission.
Oh, jeez! How? What?
Said, it sounds like the Tenryo Commission has rebelled already.
Jeez. When I said rebellion,
I don't mean betraying the Shogunate. I mean, inciting a certain someone to betray the Tenryo Commission.
Like Kujosara?
If we manage to convince her, sure, we'll be able to get you another audience with the Raiden Shogun.
Don't be so coy.
I'll give you a clue. She's currently in charge of the Shogun's army.
Yep.
She visits the shrine at this time every month.
Kujosara.
She also appears to be standing right behind you.
Kujosara.
You've got some nerve showing up here in the shrine when there's an active warrant for your arrest. Don't even think about trying anything. Surrender now. You're coming with me to headquarters. Seize her!
Of course.
Affirmative.
Kujosara!
It seems that you're forgetting. This is the Grand Narukami Shrine. Use of force here is strictly forbidden. Before you proceed, which of you would like to face criminal charges for dishonoring the Shogun,
She's... She becomes terrifying! Thank you for the protection. Thank
GI,
you.
Please tell me you are not sheltering a wanted criminal here.
No.
We're just friends. I don't see what sheltering has to do with it. Tell your subordinates to leave. We have things to discuss.
All of you outside.
As you wish.
Oh, man.
I'm a little curious. Does it not also dishonor the Shogun to hide a wanted criminal at her grand shrine?
You're the same as,
ever.
Kujosara. No one can match you when it comes to loyalty to the Shogun.
As a servant, loyalty to the Shogun is my duty. And as a warrior, I dedicate my life to following the way of the Shogun.
And she's an electro buffer, so yeah, this makes sense.
She will one day seize your vision too.
The vision hunt decree is the Shogun's chosen course, and I shall not question it.
Yeah, Mika's got a point though.
Oh, it's tragic. Such wholehearted devotion rendered meaningless by circumstance. Have you been kept in the dark, or are you the only one left in the light?
Yes.
Lady Guji, I need you to be direct. Tell me exactly what you mean.
The Vision Hunt Decree is a trap. Part of a Fatui plot to bring Inazuma to its knees. And your masters, the Kujo clan of the Tenryo Commission, they're the ones keeping the truth from reaching the Shogun.
You're saying the Kujo clan betrayed the Shogunate?
Yes.
Yes, that's exactly what I'm saying.
Guji Yai! Your allegation is not only dangerous, but ridiculous. The Tri-Commission has served the Shogun since ancient times and remains absolutely loyal to this day. Ever since I was adopted by the Kujo clan,
I've
seen and heard nothing but pure devotion toward the Shogun. At every level of the Tenryo Commission, especially from the head of the clan, Kujo Takayuki.
So she's trying to prove something. And just her loyalty to not just to the Shogun, but to her family, and above all, to herself. Feel bad for her. I feel bad for her.
He reveres the Musou no Hitotachi more than anyone. My own respect for the Shogun pales in comparison to his. How could he ever even dream of acting against the Shogun?
3 days. Come back here in 3 days, and I will show you the evidence. As a Guji, there's one thing I know very well. People believe whatever they want to believe. Some things you do not see.
Simply because you do not wish to look. That... Yaibiko is just...
And so, it falls to me to place the truth before your eyes. In all its ugliness.
Yep.
I'll be here. But if I don't see any evidence, I will demand a formal apology for slandering the Kujo clan. Also, she will have to come with me.
Wonderful. Then I'll see you in 3 days. I look forward to it very much.
Oh, man.
Why are you always asking so many questions? Of course not.
Yes.
I just had to say something because I clearly wasn't convincing her.
Well, we could go out and find said evidence.
Not entirely unexpected.
As plans go, changing the deity's mind is a huge gamble to begin with. We can't expect to be in control of every last detail when we're facing off against a god, can we?
Okay, but... what are we gonna do, though? We only have 3 days!
If we want to get our evidence, we're going to need some help. Now, come with me. We must awaken the professional.
The professional? I wonder who that is. But as I was saying before I was somewhat interrupted by popping back into the shrine, Wednesday will be another Genshin stream. Mainly because the banners are going to switch over from Risley and Venti's banner to Fiorina and Baiju. So we're going to do what we always do, and that is do our test runs, see if we like the playstyle. And maybe do a couple polls depending on what we do. Or at least depending on how the playstyle ends up being. And is there an Oculus here? I feel like there's an Oculus here and I missed it. I'm not necessarily going to worry about it right now, though.
Where do you want to go next?
And then Friday will be another episode of Pokemon Zeta. Proof of guilt. Alright. Let's see what we're doing here. Oh, man. Yaimiko is scary. And this is really sad to say, but I do regret pulling for Yaimiko when her banner was out. Not because she's a bad character, it's just at the same time she was paired with Yoimiya, and Yoimiya would have been a better fit for me at the time. Alright, so we need to be smart here. Or at least try to figure out where the heck we're going. Find the helper who Yoimiko spoke of. Professional watch, it's going to be Toma. Wait. There's a little Daruma. Sayu's the professional? This is adorable! That's not necessarily a tanuki, but okay. And it certainly wasn't a toy.
What's going on? Paimon's never seen one of these before.
Never seen a you.
I'm a Mujina.
Mujina? Hey, Rose, I don't know if you're still awake, but can you kind of give me some insight into what Sayu actually is? Aw. Either way, she's cute.
I'm so tired. If I don't get enough sleep, it'll stunt my growth.
Aw. Do not underestimate Sayu.
She is a member of the Shiumatsuban, a genuine bona fide ninja.
He's a ninja?
Wow, a ninja? So was that one of those legendary ninja transformation techniques?
No, I think she just does that.
Belongs to the Yashiro Commission, a secret unit under Kamisato Ayato. Now, Kamisato Ayato and the Yashiro Commission are neutral
parties.
So I have no right to give orders to the Shiumatsuban. However, convincing their most chronically lazy member to help us is well within my abilities.
Really?
Here's what I need you to do. Go into town and find evidence of the Tenryo Commission's betrayal.
Oh, this is gonna be good.
For me to be seen there myself.
Fair.
Make it sound so simple, but
I don't know what you're looking for.
Oh, I thought you would have figured it out by now. All right then, I'll indulge you with a little more information. For a complete outsider, probing the inner workings of the Tenryo Commission is nigh on impossible.
Fair enough.
But since the three commissions work together to serve the Shogun, they have a close relationship. Someone from one of the other commissions might have an easier job of figuring out what they're up to.
A Shiro Commission!
Now you're following me.
The Shogun's so we need to report back to Ayaka.
For you yet. But with the help of this Shiro ninja, I'm sure you'll be able to rendezvous
or
with
your
friends. Don't forget, we're on a tight schedule here. Be sure to bring back the evidence in good time.
I can certainly try. All right, so we need to go back to the tea house. Hopefully Ayaka will be there waiting. I genuinely hope she is, because trying to find her... Yeah, no. So what the heck is a Mujina? I've never heard of that yokai before. And do they all just have the ability to turn into some sort of Dorima doll? That is really cute. I wish I had somebody in chat who could actually look that up. Follow the sparkly road. We have a sparkly road, so we must follow it. And you will get to see the cutest tea house owner ever! Dog! and I wish you could pet him so much, because he deserves all of the pets. I need to stay awake. I'm only 30 minutes in. First things first, Tarumaru! He's the best boy! Woof! Woof! He's the best boy and deserves all the pets. And Toma's... He's here! It's okay! Yay!
What brings you here?
What is Sayu doing here?
Did you meet with the resistance? How's the battle going? Is it safe for me to come out yet?
Toma. Deep breath.
We saw people patrolling on our way here.
So, it's still not over. I guess you came here because you have something to discuss?
Yes, sir.
I'll get someone to call for Miss Kamisato. Bear with me for 1 second.
Just a moment.
I see. You have been through a lot since we last met.
I should hope so.
I understand. You need evidence of the Tenryo Commission's betrayal. Let me think. Now that you mention it, there is one thing that has always concerned me. The Shogun's army has been at war with the Resistance for a long time now, but not once has the Shogun ever inquired about it.
Does she need to?
I used to think that she simply didn't care, but looking at it now, perhaps the problem all along has been with the Tenryo Commission's reports to the Shogun.
What do you mean?
The Tenryo Commission presides over domestic military affairs. If they ever had any intention of concealing information in their reports, we would have no way of knowing.
Fair enough. That's a problem. That is a big problem.
Meanwhile, the Shogun would incorrectly conclude that the Vision Hunt decree poses no threat and would stick to her decision. If we had access to their reports, it would confirm everything.
But as I recall, the only person authorized to access that kind of official documentation is Kujo Takayuki. It's heavily guarded, too. Even with Sayu's help, swiping a document from under their noses is no easy task.
If only there was a way we could distract the guards just for long enough.
A distraction, you say?
Yoimi is fireworks!
That's a very Toma-sounding suggestion.
I mean, it worked the first time!
But it's a reasonable one. The statue of the omnipresent god is right by the Tenryo Commission.
If but a fireworks near the statue, they certainly wouldn't ignore it.
They certainly wouldn't ignore it. While they were preoccupied with that, Sayu could infiltrate the Tenryo Commission and take the report, as well as any other evidence she might find.
I just hope she's awake and actually hearing this.
Great! It feels like I'm getting closer and closer to being a free man again.
Toma, we're trying.
It feels like it's been an eternity since we last sat down and talked like this. Well, it certainly felt like it to me. I've been looking forward to seeing you again every day since I got here.
Really?
The tea house used to be my favorite hiding place, but now... I've honestly lost track of how long it's been since I last set foot outside of here. Oh man, I want to go to the hot spring so badly.
Poor Toma.
Let's focus on the issue at hand. The sooner the Vision Hunt decree is abolished, The sooner Toma will be free. This was a reunion of sorts, but there's no time to catch up. We'll celebrate properly when it's all over.
Yes, ma'am.
Ooh, let's play the hot pot game again.
When it's over.
Yeah, thinking
about this? Hey! Just because he won?
The Tenryo Commission is heavily guarded. Be careful when you get near. Let's meet back here afterwards.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. And we'll actually get to talk with another one of my favorite characters in this game. At least in terms of a character perspective. Tarumaru! Good boy. A very good boy. So we go talk to Yuimiya, we set off the fireworks, Sayu hopefully does her thing, and let's go relatively, I hope? Seriously, I hope? Alright, let's follow the sparkly road. It's actually kind of nice to be walking through the city once again. Oh, and I'm not necessarily worried about the world quests right now. I'll pick them up eventually, but right now the goal is to get through our story. Also, they have a dog! That's lovely.
Yuimiya, we need an extra large firework. The super duper big kind!
We need your help. Here's the situation. Jenny, you are amazing.
So powerful that I haven't found anywhere I can test it out yet. May as well give it to you. Let me know how it turns out. Don't forget, move well away from it after you light the fuse, and try to avoid burning your clothes. Also, it's best that you cover your ears.
Why does Paimon feel so nervous all of a sudden?
Because we are actively holding onto a firework. You have no idea.
We'll give it a try. Thanks, Yuimiya.
Oh, you have no idea.
Well, we've got our distraction. Now we just need to wait for nightfall.
That might require a little bit of time travel. Yep, that's not time travel. This is time travel. It's about as close as we're gonna get it. Alright. Go set up a bomb. Let's go set off a bomb. I mean, mean, aside from the fact that this is quite literally a ticking time bomb of a plot. I mean, we're already wanted criminals. Surely it, well, I shouldn't say that. It's probably going to get worse in some way. Yes, is there a waypoint nearby? Probably. Do I mind? Not. Well, there is a waypoint nearby. Okay.
You! The warrant is for your arrest!
Run. I literally just... Oh, okay. So I can't just walk in there. No problem. No problems. Just navigate. That's Shogunate Soldier! Soldier! Crap! And there's one there, too. Guys! Making this a little difficult. Not gonna lie. Lily Pete, thank you for doing Sayu so much.
After I get the document, let's meet back at Komori Tea House, okay? Also, if I do get caught, please come rescue me.
I will try.
Is this really a good idea?
I thought we...
Anyway, let's make our way to the statue. Careful, Dazik. Watch out for guards and don't get caught.
Hello, stealth section. I'm sorry, what? There is no stealth section. I mean, oh, they're all literally like right there. What?
For a wanted.
Quick. Dang it. Okay. Okay. We need to do this a little bit more. Oh. Thank you for sending me back to an easier spot. Here we go. Okay, now is not the time. Better than nothing, Paimon! Yes! there. I love it so much. You are doing well, computer. Keep it up. Got an achievement? Probably a story achievement, but regardless, we got one. Set off a firework to distract the guards. That is 5 more gems toward our next pull, which will be Wednesday. I have news. We lit the firework and bolted.
Let's wait for news from Sayu.
Sayu's back! Yay!
I know exercise helps you grow, but this was a little too much exercise.
Aww. Okay, that's a reference to Sayu's skill. Instead of the normal swirl that she can do, she rolls like Sonic. Actually, really, really cute.
No, I can't sleep yet. There was something important I was supposed to do. I didn't know how to find a document you guys were talking about.
So I just swiped a whole bunch of stuff.
Here you go. I'm going to sleep now.
Well, maybe we can find something in the documents that Sayu did manage to get.
My lady, what are we looking at?
This sealed envelope must be an official report that the Tenryou Commission is preparing to present to the Shogun. In addition, we have correspondence with the Fatui.
Well done, Sayu.
It seems that Kujiyai was right. They have been fomenting unrest behind the scenes. This should be ample evidence. Please take them to Kujiyai. I trust you will have a plan for the next step. I will also gather some people to try and root out the rest of the Fatui and Inazuma.
Still, mind yourself when you face the Shogun. I still get goosebumps just thinking about her drawing that blade.
Again. We'll just have to trust Fujii. She is close to the Shogun, so maybe she will have a way.
Here's hoping.
If I don't remember correctly, it should be time for a meeting with Yaniko soon. Let's pack up our things and get ready to head to the Grand Narukami Shrine.
Oh boy. And it is Judgment Day, my friends. We shall be judged. By Yaimiko and Kujisara. Which, yeesh. Yeesh. That's a scary thought. Oh boy. Boy. And we're back.
Lady Guji, here I am, as promised. Rest assured, I came here alone and told no one about this trip.
I knew you would keep your promise after all. I'm sure you've barely been able to take your mind off it these past few days. Have you managed to get any sleep at all?
You're quite mistaken. I would never doubt the leaders of my clan.
I'm sorry, but she caught you red-handed, Sara.
So, where is your proof?
Right here.
Ah, how wonderful. Everyone's keeping their promises today.
Oh, you wouldn't believe what we had to go through to get our hands on this stuff.
Hand them to Sara. She can examine them for herself.
What is this?
Now is not the time to freeze.
I see this document bears the official seal of the head of the Cujo clan. And it doesn't look like a forgery.
Okay, I'm going to read this. Praise be to the great and excellent Ogosho, the almighty shogun, whose glorious lightning fills the skies. May your eternal way spread to the furthest seas, and may your mighty name resound like thunder in every corner of the realm. Submitted by Tenryo Commissioner Takayuki of the Cujo clan. The Vigilant Hunt Decree proceeds at a great pace and without obstacle. By the grace and might of your excellency, the wayward have been quashed and the deserters have returned. All in the land bow to your will in reverence and gratitude in their hearts. Peace now endures throughout the land of Inazuma thanks to the divine power of your excellency. Okay.
I don't understand. Not a single word about the resistance, Sangonomiya, or the situation on the front line. What about the soldiers who gave their lives on the front line, or the hardship endured by the people? Do they deserve no mention? Utter disregard for human life. Why would they want to hide it?
Keep reading.
For the sake of the Vision Hunt Decree, of course. Don't you think the Shogun might reconsider her policy if all of the things you just mentioned appeared in this report?
So, the Tenryo Commission, they are deliberately deceiving the Shogun?
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Now, who else do you think might be benefiting from the Vision Hunt Decree?
So I have a confidential letter.
This is a letter from the Tenryo Commission to the Fatui! The head of the Cujo clan kept this a secret from the Shogun too!
Well, the things you wanted to see, but also wished not to see, are here before you. Surely, you aren't planning to turn a blind eye to them?
So everything I've ever held on to, it's all... How could they? Ugh! This betrayal is unforgivable! Takayuki, you've got some explaining to do!
And she's gone. The Shogun's army is without a leader for now.
Let's catch up with him.
Why?
Hold on, traveler. There's something else we need to discuss.
Huh?
Last time you entered the plane of Euthymia, it was in front of the statue of the omnipresent god, correct?
Correct.
You must find a way to recreate the circumstances of that day. You can get the Raiden Shogun to open her heart to you once more before the statue of the omnipresent god. You will have the opportunity you need.
Well, I will do my best.
A farewell gift.
What is it?
The Omomori from the Grand Narukami Shrine are very potent indeed. I thought I'd put one aside for you.
I will treasure it.
If you find yourself at your wit's end, take it out and see what happens. Maybe your prayers will be answered, and all your problems will disappear in the blink of an eye. Or if you ever think about me during your journey, take it out, won't you? Who knows? Maybe I'll just end up appearing right in front of you.
Cut it out, Fox Lady! This isn't the time or place to be poking fun at the Traveler!
She's not! She's foreshadowing!
I'm sorry. Well then.
Cat?
Face my hopeless fool of a friend. I'm counting on you.
Courage is here to grant her blessing. I hope. For those of you who don't know, Courage is my cat. So if I stop at seemingly random points, it's because she is demanding pets. And who am I but a human who needs to oblige? Blind loyalty, reckless courage. This is going to be interesting. So we are back in the city. Oh boy. Oh, this is gonna be nuts. Actually get to fight the Shogun today. To which I say, I hope not. This is gonna be a tough fight if that's the case. Sara!
You followed me here? You've got guts, I'll give you that.
Look, we just want to talk.
Since you are a witness, I suppose I can shield you from arrest. At least until I have received an explanation from Takayuki. But if it turns out that you have been deceptive in this matter, then not only will you be arrested immediately, but you'll also be charged with one more crime. Do I make myself clear?
Crystal.
Good.
Oh boy. I've got a bad feeling. I've got a bad feeling. Well, let's try it. And if I need to call in the big guns, I'll call in the big guns later. Oh, man. I'm nervous. Why? Because we're dealing with the Kanjo Commission, which means soldiers for the Shogun. Also, Kudrosara isn't definitively on our side.
Orders from the top.
Oh.
Yeah.
Nothing
to fear. Solidify.
Not use Kudrosara unless we absolutely need to use Kudrosara. She's an excellent buffer, though. Decking the heck out of these men. That a lawman from Fontaine is the one that is doing most of the fighting around here. Guards. Got it! Pillar didn't work! Come on, I need that pillar. I need that shield. Only, thank you.
No, my sword.
As
soldiers,
this isn't timed. Because if this was timed, I would be having issues.
I must withdraw.
Yes. That man ended up in a wall. Risley, you are just decking this man super good, but we are in need of...
Rain, outline for the earth.
Oh, Kudra's got a burst. Awesome.
I won't forget this. Brace yourself.
Easy. Flip into St. Joe, set up his swords, her healing melody. Switching to Sara. And then we'll proceed to beat the crap out of the affair's head. Barbara, there we go. Sir, I hate to tell you this, but you're going to lose. I don't care if it takes 30, it takes an hour, you are going to lose. I don't care how many men I have to go through in order to prove that point.
Solidify! Soldiers, quick! Watch your step!
Rain, help me. There we go. Good fight! Good fight!
Sara, have you gone insane? How dare you disregard my orders?
Master, I... Master Takayuki, I've seen the report to the throne and the letter to the Fatui. Please, tell me why.
So this is how my documents went missing from headquarters. You stole them.
Not quite.
Should I take your words to mean that these documents were not forgeries? They were really penned by your own hand. Please, tell me, Master. I need to know. Has the Tenryo Commission really betrayed the Shogunate?
Yes, I have dealings with the Fatui, and yes, the report you saw was penned by my hand.
He just came right out and admitted it.
And this is where you, Sara, put an arrow through his throat.
Diplomats from Snezhnaya promised a very generous reward indeed. And all they requested of me in return was to see that the Vision Hunt decree is upheld. For too long, the Kujo clan's position has been coveted by so many. There is no shortage of clans who will tear us down at the first opportunity. So, when the chance arose to gain the backing of another powerful nation and crack down on our enemies at the same time, it appeared to me to be an excellent deal. I simply saw no need to inform you, Sara.
But you worship the Shogun. How can you betray her after all this time and act like it's nothing?
Betrayal? How can you call this a betrayal? The Fatui may think they are using me, but the reverse is true.
No.
What could they possibly hope to achieve?
No, no, sir. You were being used.
When the lightning strikes in Inazuma, they shall fall to their knees and tremble, paralyzed by fear and trepidation. After all, none can contend with the supreme power of the almighty Raiden Shogun and the Musou no Hitotachi.
His intent wasn't to betray her.
She doesn't worship the Raiden Shogun herself, but her power as a warrior, especially the Musou no Hitotachi. In fact, she seems to be way too into it.
But Master, what about loyalty? Ever since I was adopted by the Kujo clan, you taught me the importance of loyalty from servants to their superiors. But it's clear to me now that you want my loyalties to stop with the Kujo clan. So you were scared that I would betray you one day? You hypocrite! Preaching about virtue just to mask your own wretched selfishness!
Selfishness? I am but safeguarding the eternity of the Kujo clan.
No, no, you're not.
Quite sure the Almighty Shogun would be sympathetic to that. as with the former head of our clan.
Hate to say it, but his ego is getting in the way. If he thinks the Cujo clan is a match for the Fatui, Paimon thinks he's in for a nasty surprise.
Let's see what Sara thinks.
Vision hunt decree in the past. I asked myself, is this truly the correct thing to do? Even though it goes against what I know in my heart to be right. But I chose to obey the Shogun. For as long as she leads the way, who among us is qualified to judge between right and wrong when we have not yet reached the end of the path? But now I realize that the path of eternity is one without end, while this path, it has long since been defiled by your selfish ways.
Again, she's got a point.
Tell the Shogun the truth about all this. If nothing else, my conscience will be clear.
Stubborn and futile. Report to the Shogun if you so wish. The Cujo clan's position is now unshakable, and nothing you can do will change this. The Shogun is at Tenshukaku receiving a Snezhnayan diplomat.
Signora!
By the name of Signora.
Signora's the one behind all this? Not her again! Way back in Rito, Lady Hiragi said something about the Kanjo Commissioner meeting with an arrogant sounding woman.
Should have known.
Should have known.
A diplomat from Snezhnaya? Well, if she thinks she's leaving Inazuma in one piece, she's got another thing coming.
Either way, we've got a score to settle.
All right then, let's do this.
Oh boy. Oh sweet, loot. Awesome. Oh, this is not gonna end well. Should I do the Signora fight today? Or should I hold off for next week? There might be a little more before that fight, so let's see where it goes, and if we're confronting Signora, we're confronting Signora. Not gonna end well. To Tenshikaku we go! Oh, it's actually not too far from here. Nice. Oh, this is not gonna end well. Oh no. Seeing the Shogunate soldiers. Oh man. Sara, wait, this is bad news. This is bad news. Narukami Island Tenshikaku. Oh man. Do I want to do it now? Oh! Riot? Yeah. Again, let's try it. If we fail, then, well, we fail. But. Ugh. I'm not gonna give up. Not now. Not ever. Oh, man. We are in a single throne room. Signora!
Tenshikaku, I might have mistaken it for some kind of street market. Have you learned your lesson now?
Oh no! What has she done to Kujo-sama?
The right to punish Inazumans for their crimes is mine alone. Not yours, Signora.
Then I apologize, Almighty Shogun.
I know, Signora!
I know, you can't get me out of your mind. But you really don't need to call my name. Don't go thinking I'm surprised to see you here. I'm well aware that you hate
you're trying to seize control.
So to expose my crimes in front of the Shogun.
She doesn't take us seriously at all!
For all of those
Stop
who have lost their village,
visions. About. They were nobodies to begin with, and their names will be forgotten. But is that not the greatest honor they could hope for? In their tiny little lives, Almighty Shogun. Do correct me if I'm wrong.
Prevent his gnosis.
History. The Tsaritsa's dream is the noblest. These other mundane details you insist on mentioning, they're just necessary sacrifices. That's all.
It's time for me to put a stop to this.
For what it's worth, I've grown tired of seeing you around as well. But before you go saying something you can't take back, remember that you're Inazuma's most wanted criminal. I suggest you consider your circumstances very carefully. Charging into Tenshukaku uninvited and lecturing me in front of the Shogun wasn't the brightest move. Don't you think it's time you stopped digging? I'm not sure you realize quite how much distance there is between us, both in status and in strength.
I challenge you to a duel before the throne.
Well,
proceed. My, you're full of surprises today. So you've learned to make the law of the land work for you too. I'll admit that I never expected to be in a situation where the two of us were on equal footing. You are aware that the loser must die. Are you sure?
Traveler!
Then I will deign to share this last dance with you. Till death do us part!
Right. Here we go. Oh, before I get too far ahead, we have a little extra trick up our sleeve in the form of goulash.
A lesson on harbinger power and elegance?
As you wish. Come on.
Detestable. Into the frozen void.
Careless. Stabilized. Solidify.
Nope, we are cold. Way too cold. Where's the butterfly? There it is.
Stabilize.
Into the frozen void.
You wish. Ah.
Detestable.
Gather.
Not actually doing any damage to her.
That... Into the frozen void.
Nope. Nope. No, thank you. Circumstances that I am in, and I am cold.
Into the frozen void.
Set up. And I think this is just the first phase. Hold.
I see your power.
The pale flame smolders.
Okay, I need to use food. I need to use food. One Zhongli mainly. All right, the man's fed. Let's do this. I'll admit, I don't appreciate the cold, but
the Tsaritsa's benevolence.
But it's about to get worse. And that's why Signora's got a delusion of her own. And it just so happens to be Pyro. Season Witch of Embers. Oh, this fight's not over yet.
Pale flame, lay waste to frozen shell and witness my suffering. In fires of sin and retribution, your soul will be incinerated.
This is the heat. So, if memory serves,
embrace,
you can use one of these to cool down. Oh, this is... Ow. I appreciate the fight, Signora. Brava, indeed. And I need to go to the next thing to cool off.
Quake.
Who dares call me a witch?
Um,
gather.
I can think of several other names for you. If you're so inclined. I'm not particularly fond of it, actually. Yes, go Barbara, go indeed.
Rise.
It really doesn't help when you've charred the corners of the room. She's vaping everything off.
Stabilize.
So much for trying to get some hydro application on. It's a little... Duh!
Yeah.
It is very difficult when she's just blowing everything away. Come on, Risley. It's done. And if we're not... Hang on. Hang on, bud.
Not every wound will heal.
Oh, Senora! Come on.
Solidify. I will have order.
Friendly shield is coming in clutch here.
Gather.
As long as I can make sure that it stays up. If it can't stay up, then I've got issues. You are
a witch.
Like I said, I can think of many other names for you.
Stabilize.
But Signora.
Yeah.
Well met indeed. Whew.
So strong, but how?
I've grown since we last met. Or did you forget? Uh-oh. Wait, what?
I am a Snishnayan diplomat. You know what happens if you lay a finger on me. I swear, if you strike me, I will make sure. The Fatui will make sure that your precious Inazuma...
And thus, the Crimson Witch is no more. Beautiful.
You are the enemy of eternity. But as the victor, I acknowledge your honor. Therefore, I shall allow you to leave Tenshukaku alive.
Thank you. Because, yeah, I'm not ready for a fight with Raiden just yet. Or I suppose it's technically round two. Regardless. Not yet. Not yet.
The Raiden Shogun isn't gonna let us off just like that, right?
No. She's not. What?
Oh, the air feels suffocating. It must be the Raiden Shogun's almightiness.
I'm not touching anything. We're just moving. Okay, cool. Signora is slain.
One strike from the Shogun and now Signora is gone. She got what she deserved. But Paimon still can't help but feel upset. Why are they doing it? Why are the Harbingers collecting all the Nosy?
Something's going on! I can't necessarily do QTEs, Hoyle! Thankfully, there isn't... Dang it. Holding the button would have been a little bit better, but that's just me. So the Muso no Hitotachi.
Also, when the Shogun executed Signora with the Muso no Hitotachi, it was unbelievably powerful. It seems impossible to defend against. And if so, we've got no hope whatsoever of defeating her in combat.
Emika's plan.
So, to recap, Yamiko wants us to go back inside the plane of Euthymia by the statue of the Omnipresent God. Oh, but we'll be like lambs to the slaughter, won't we? Oh, maybe we could put this plan on hold for a while?
I doubt it, Paimon. I really do. Another QTE! Hoyo, what the heck?
Are you okay? You're so silent.
That being said, it is a fairly lenient, a fairly lenient, quick time of
running. There's a lot of noise coming from outside Tenshikaku. Has a fight broken out or something?
Possibly.
Well, the guards seem really nervous. Well, let's go see what the situation is, shall we?
We have no choice. I can't move. Okay. Can I have control of my game again? Uh-oh. Resistance fighters! Kazuha and Goru! Oh no. Kazuha's second vision!
There will always be those who dare to break the lightning's glow.
Kazuha to the rescue! Run! The time we run! The vision! Oh, jeez. All the visions are waking up. Jins! Have to fight. Now's our chance. Hello, Raiden. Or should I say,
so we meet again.
A. Well, it's gonna be a real fight to finish this one. Wish me luck.
Indulge my curiosity. What is the reason that I find you standing here before me once again? Do you hope your foolhardiness will shelter those people? Or was it simply a means of seeking an audience with me?
But do we have deceived the Raiden Shogun?
Surely you didn't rouse me from my state of eternal meditation only to tell me this. If so, then you underestimate me. I am quite well informed about the Vision Hunt decree.
You know what's going on out there?
So, only everything that pertains to eternity. The Vision Hunt decree has my tacit approval. The Fatui's actions thus far do not constitute a threat to eternity.
But
otherwise, they would have been purged long ago.
But it's damaging the people.
Ambition is inherently incompatible with eternity. What you might not realize is that all too often, people have far more to lose by chasing their dreams. Consider this. No one will lose their life on account of having their vision taken away.
I hate to disagree with you there.
Rather, those who have lost their lives are the ones who insisted on pursuing their own aspirations. Are they not?
To pay.
Traveler, your existence is unique in my eyes. There seems to be limitless uncertainty in you. To put it another way, you are the furthest thing from eternity. So, I won't insist that you comprehend the meaning of my actions. What matters is that I tread the path of eternity on my people's behalf.
So this is your plan, Thymia. It is created by your consciousness, right?
I'm surprised you understand it so well. Anyway, you're looking for a chance to shake my will, aren't you?
No, not really. I'm here to take you down. By force.
So be it. Well then, you who would defy eternity, time for you to enlighten me.
And I've got a full round of bursts.
Excessive yearning leads to inevitable destruction.
Are going to lose.
This ends
Ray
now.
Outlines your fate. Let me
make sure that's set up. Make sure Barbara's healing is set up. And you didn't zip around so much. Will admit, I don't necessarily like dealing with you. Why? Because you those things. Again. I'd rather you didn't. All honesty. Risley. Set that up. Set up the healing. Come on, buddy. this. Ow.
Strike dead.
Solidify.
No, my sword.
Barbara, you could. Sleeve. I am knocking her down just a little bit at a time. And that's what's gonna give us the edge.
Rain outlines your fate.
Let's dance.
It's been a pleasure and a dance, Miss Shogun. Unfortunately, it all has to end here. And I can't use skill. It's where you actually use the where is it? Here we go. You can't actually use the item. What the heck? Because now would be the perfect time to use it. Ah! This at you if I have to. Yes! We survived long enough. Perfect. Computer, this is a bad time. Really bad time.
Dear me, aren't you cutting it rather close?
Maybe you!
Miko, this was your doing?
Yes.
Now. Don't forget who taught you how to place your consciousness in objects. Surely you don't think your ambition alone is enough to shake Ace's will, do you? Mm-hmm. Though you alone are here, they too have ambitions, which they long since entrusted to you.
By all means.
Now then, close your eyes.
Ayaka? Kazuo? Tepei? And everyone else. You're ending this. Now! What?
We can abolish the Vision Hunt Decree.
For existence. Welcome to phase two, yeah?
Gather. Order guide.
All will be severed. As it were, the fleeting shadow. Rain cutter.
Set up the healing dot and Risley, let's. Switch.
This is order.
And I will collect the achievement afterward.
All returns to silence.
Ah!
Rain outlines your fate.
How?
All will be severed.
To live through that. Jesus.
Solidify.
Complete shadow.
Nothing to. I will have order.
John Lee's meteor. And it's constant uptime. Rose Rain Swords, Barbara's Healing.
Your verdict is decided.
Hey, you're starting to repeat yourself. Risley! Alright, hang on. Get on the shield. Pop the meteor. And because we need the meteor. Switching to Sing Cho. Barbara's healing again. And keep in mind, I'm also underleveled for this. In theory. So the fact that I'm doing so well is actually a testament to my skill. Or at least... Oh. It's not a testament to my skill, it's a testament to how much preparation I've done leading up to this point. It wasn't the shield. I need the shield. Let's finish this. Let's finish this as we need to. And it took the meteor! She took the meteor! You're in the face! Testament! The Raiden Shogun! On the inside. Yo. You did it.
You've lost, eh?
You did it!
Trust your people, and in the power of their ambitions. These ambitions have transcended space and time. They are something that no one can snuff out.
When people move forward with all their might, they surpass the gods' expectations.
Is this a lesson you learned from your journey in Liyue? There are nations where humans cast their god aside and stride forward.
So we did it.
Just abandon the
monster did it.
You and I have both witnessed the great loss that progress can bring. Eternity. Eternity is the only way.
Do I have to beat it out of you again?
When lightning flashes, it casts a shadow. My name means shadow.
Yeah?
With my blade, I purged all obstacles to progress.
Yep.
And yet, something was lost as each step forward.
Was that a reference to Oz?
I even lost her.
Her being her sister.
The tales are still retold in the shade of every thunder sakura. But the wounds left on our nation by that terrible loss still ache. Never stop searching, even if only for a brief flash of light. If nothing else, we have the present moment. She said that once. But I've seen a nation stride forward and lose everything to the heavenly principles. Perhaps only if time stands still will the lightning's glow never fade.
I hate to tell you this, but no.
It's a fragile illusion. Only eternity can bring us closer to the heavenly principles. I am no longer the shadow. Mine is the most supreme and noble form. Let power over the realm be vested within me. In this form shall I honor my subject's dream for a land of eternity, unchanging forevermore.
Heavenly principles. Irrelevant nonsense as far as I'm concerned.
Of course.
When all's said and done, all you really want is to protect your beloved Inazuma forever and ever. Isn't that right?
Mm-hmm.
That would be something of an oversimplification.
But is this nation worth existing for eternity? Stripped of ambitions, stripped of the potential for change. It does nothing more than simply exist. It is a hollow shell of a nation. I wonder what loss would it really be to anyone if such a nation were destroyed?
Miko, retract your words. Never changing eternity is the promise I made to my people.
But what your people need from you is not your promises. They want your attention. Your divine gaze.
You mean visions? Humans have a lifespan of barely 100 years. They cannot afford to bear any extra losses. But I have experienced it all. That is why I have chosen to guide them along the correct path toward eternity.
Unfortunately, what A fails to understand here is that there is no correct path. You need to find it yourself.
But eternity is far too cruel a fate for you, A.
For me?
Not only have you stopped paying attention to the world, but you've stopped paying attention to yourself. It must have been terribly lonely here, all alone, for centuries on end.
But it is necessary.
You will miss much by refusing progress. You seek to prevent loss, but have you considered all you are losing by remaining here in stasis for all eternity? You are obviously lonely, and yet, for the sake of eternity, you choose to stretch your loneliness out to infinity. Tell me this. Why is the sky here that was once so dark glowing again? Why now? This is your plane of Euphania. It's your inner world. So it can only mean that you are happy to see me again. You have found the loneliness here unbearable for a long time now, haven't you?
I have nothing to say to that.
But I have so much to say to you. Let me tell you all that has happened over the last few centuries.
How long will that take?
As a fox envoy, I have an excellent memory. I recall every detail of the last few centuries with perfect clarity. So it will probably take me another few centuries to relay it to you.
Way to go, Miko!
Miko, I never thought I would have the chance to meet with you like this again. Seeing you again is a change to eternity.
And a very nice surprise.
A very nice surprise.
Since you are willing to admit that, I suppose that means we can still be friends?
What a childish conversation this is. Anyway, now that I have been defeated by you and your plan, I will honor your wish to abolish the Vision Hunt Decree. But, with regards to eternity, and the question of whether this nation should move forward, I need time to give it some thought.
You are the one who's been acting like a child from the very beginning. As promised, the Raiden Shogun abolished the Vision Hunt Decree. Finally, her people's wishes penetrated her locked heart. Beyond the plane of Euthymia, she saw what eternity means in the eyes of the world.
Oh. on the computer just a little longer, I promise. When
ambition burns brightly, the gods will cast their gaze upon you. Some ambitions have the power to heal wounds, to bring victory, to inspire hope. But some ambitions outlive their masters long after the soul ascends.
And go coming. Yes.
They remain as they were in the beginning. Burning bright and true. For all eternity.
We did it. We defeated the Shogun. I didn't think I'd be able to do it in one fall, but we did it! And next time might be a little bit of a side quest. Well, next time's gonna be the banner pull. The time after that, it's probably gonna be a little bit of side questing, just to, you know, pick up the pieces and explore the world a little bit more before we move on to Sumeru and then eventually Fontaine.
So what did you guys do in the Riding Shogun's plane of Euthymia anyway?
We fought. And yes, it was all thanks to Yamiko.
I'm always super worried, you know. So maybe the reason Yamiko is looking for us now is because she wants to thank us. Let's go find her.
Somehow, I don't think it's that simple. But we can certainly pay a visit. Miss Miko.
Triumphant traveler. And why might you be visiting the shrine? A sign of piety, perhaps.
You wanted to
they
talk to us.
They literally told us to come meet you here!
I was just joking. I've been waiting for you.
Seems like someone's in a pretty good mood.
Mm-hmm. Catching up with an old friend I hadn't seen in years was truly delightful. By the way, I heard that you had a duel before the throne. With a Fatui Harbinger, no less. Courageous and astute. I must say, I am most impressed.
It was spur-of-the-moment decision.
Put on in a duel means that your strength exceeds my expectations. Still, you did end up victorious. I gather congratulations are in order.
Sure feels good to finally thwart the Fatui plan for once.
Oh, you have no idea.
Wait a second. Did you say gnosis? As in, the little thing that looks something like a chess piece.
Yep, that's the one. You've seen one too? Gnoses belong to the Seven. They're what keep them connected to Celestia.
Oh, god damn it.
Oh.
What's wrong?
Oh, dear.
I handed that over.
To...
You did what now?
Well, how else was I supposed to save your skin from the Balladeer, exactly?
So it's long gone,
then. The Balladeer is number 6 of the Fatui Harbingers. In terms of strength, he's superior to Signora. I'm not the kind of person who risks life and limb for any old reason.
For once, Simon just does not know what to say!
So why was it in your hand? Why did you have it?
She no longer had anywhere to put it. As her erstwhile closest friend, A handed it over to me. And I've kept it in the Grand Narukami Shrine ever since. She no longer needs the power of the Gnosis.
Or at least you traded it.
She has severed ties with Celestia. Thus the Gnosis became not only useless, but also a potential source of conflict. Is that not a good bargain, exchanging it for the one at the core of the plan? Judging by the results, at least, I dare say I struck a good deal.
For now.
When you put it like that, Paimon has to agree. The Traveler is worth more than a Gnosis.
Never knew I could fetch a high price.
Gratitude, I will answer any questions you may have about the road ahead or the events of the past.
Oh.
What would you like to know about?
All right, so let's start from the top and work our way down. Jogan's puppet
was built with technology that has been lost to time. Perhaps she, as a god, is the only one privy to the knowledge of its origins. Still, there's one other thing on this topic that I suspect you may be curious to know. Before A began modifying her own godly form, she took it upon herself to create a prototype puppet.
So, you mean there are three riding shoguns?
No. The prototype was merely a proof of concept. Its appearance and intellect were not based on A. It was a test. The original plan was for A to simply discard it. But perhaps A thought this to be too cruel, because in the end, she chose only to seal the power within it. Later, this puppet wandered Inazuma as an ordinary human male with his own consciousness. Until the Fatui took an interest in him.
Not the Fatui!
Some eccentric geniuses in the ranks of the Fatui made adjustments to the prototype. Not only unsealing his power, but very likely rendering him even more formidable than his original specifications.
You don't mean...
The object of divine creation is now the one who has taken possession of the Gnosis. And the prototype puppet is now known as the Balladeer.
Great!
What a crazy story!
It is, isn't it? Who can say whether it's coincidence or destiny?
So, about the former shogun.
An outlander like you is aware that there was once a change of Electro-Archon. Few citizens of Inazuma are aware of this.
Morax told us. He said that the Electro-Archon ball has passed away.
Yes. The truth of the matter is that there were two twin gods, Baal and Beelzebul.
Twin gods?
They won the Archon War together, and when Baal established the shogunate, Beelzebul became her Kagemusha, or Shadow Warrior. In other words, she acted as Baal's body double. Beelzebul is A, with whom we are now both acquainted. Baal's name was Makoto. As far as the world was aware, there were not two, but one. They complemented each other, and they ruled Inazuma jointly. So there was no need for the public to know the truth. In fact, the name Baal and the title of Raiden Shogun was understood to refer to both of them. Right up until...
Until what?
Makoto died several hundred years ago in a war that I was not personally involved in. Since then, A has assumed the shogunate.
Losing her sister must have been super hard on A.
Honria.
That was when A began to change. Makoto was her greatest loss.
Paimon feels like she understands A a lot better now after finding that out. So what kind of god was Makoto?
I didn't spend a great deal of time with her, but my impression was she was a gentle god, who in each moment cherished the beauty of what was before her.
Wow.
And about her sibling?
I haven't a clue. I'm also unfamiliar with the god you describe.
God damn it.
you still have doubts about A, I would say they are misplaced. Not only does she not fit your description, but she voluntarily gave up her gnosis long ago, severing her ties with Celestia in the process.
Oh.
That's good to hear. Otherwise, given that I'm her familiar, it could have made our relationship rather awkward, don't you think?
Yes, ma'am.
Don't worry. We aren't looking to pick a fight with you.
I wish you the best of luck. As for your brother's whereabouts, I will use all the resources at my disposal to investigate it. And I will also borrow some of Ayato's people from the Shiumatsuban.
You.
I'll let you know if I find out anything. Consider it part of my means of thanking you.
Stuff?
After leaving Inazuma, I think it would be easiest for you to go to Sumeru.
Ooh, Sumeru! We've run into loads of scholars from there on our journey, so...
Yes, well, Sumeru is the land of the God of Wisdom, where the quest for wisdom and knowledge is never-ending. But their obsession gives rise to some truly inexplicable things. For example, in Sumeru, knowledge is holistically managed as a resource.
Huh?
Knowledge is a resource?
Yes.
Care to elaborate?
I don't know whether it was the sages or Lesser Lord Kusanali who came up with the idea.
Lesser Lord Kusanali? That's a cute name.
Oh, you haven't heard. Lesser Lord Kusanali is the deity in whom the people of Sumeru place their faith. It's their chosen term of endearment for her.
That's the term of endearment?
I'm sure you must have some things to discuss with her, too. I wish you all the best.
Well, no more questions.
Okay, then. Oh, Traveler. Do you still have the Omomori I gave you?
Of course.
Keep it safe. Is that all you intend to do with it? There was me thinking that you might hang it around your neck to show off to the world, telling everyone who inquired that it was given to you by none other than Yaimiko, the wise and beautiful.
I mean, we could do that.
Who in their right mind would do that?
Okay,
I'll stop. Now, a question for you. Traveler, what is your ambition?
To be reunited with my brother, I guess.
I see. But that is merely a small goal, based on what preoccupies you here and now. Your ambition should be something that transcends the world below and the starry sky above. Something that shines in unison with fate itself. Perhaps the reason you do not possess a vision is that such an ambition has yet to be engendered within you. It's a possibility.
Yo, I can switch elements on the fly.
Continue on your journey.
Just saying.
And maybe that moment will come to pass.
Oh, man. We did it. We finished the chapter. Heck yes. Just gonna turn in. Oh, we don't have enough sigils to turn in. But... once we get enough sigils, I can handle that. And we got a talisman from the tree. Let me collect from our adventurer's guidebook. Because we do have a reward there. Alright, so the crane returns on the wind. That's an interlude chapter. Before we get into that, I think we're going to delve into some of more of the world quests. Mainly the Chasm, Sarai Island, and maybe a few other things along the way.
Every journey has a...
not to mention that we still have our polls to do. So let's collect the achievements. I'll do my outro and we'll go from there. And it's the world. I have a little bit more primos to collect, which is very nice. Oh man, that was a fun fight. But regardless, I hope you guys enjoyed today's stream. Please make sure to leave a follow and ring that notification bell so you'll be notified the next time I go live. on the YouTube channel. Make sure to like, comment, and subscribe over there so you don't miss a recap. And you could possibly request new games for me to try out. If you're feeling particularly generous, I do have a Ko-fi link in the About section of the Twitch channel and in the description of the YouTube videos. Any money generated through that link will go back to assets on the channel in some way. Additionally, an artist friend of a friend needs some dental surgery done, and where we are, that is quite expensive. If you would like to help her out, a link to her GoFundMe is in the About section of the Twitch channel, and it's in the description of the YouTube videos. You don't have to donate, but we would definitely appreciate it if you did. And I hope to see you guys on Wednesday for our